Dear students, I extend a very warm welcome to all of you. In this series of e-learning, we will continue the study of Vrat Panchmool Dravyas. So the topic for today's discussion is the plant Agnimanth. The plant derived its name Agnimanth by the belief that when the woods or the dried branches of the tree, they are rubbed together, they ignite the fire. The process of rubbing together two things is known as manthan, and the term Agni is used for fire, hence the plant gets its name Agnimanth. There are two types of Agnimanth are there. The first one is Laghu Agnimanth, or also known as Shudra Agnimanth, and the other one is Brihat Agnimanth. Actually, there is a controversy over the correct identity of Laghu and Brihat Agnimanth. Since the Samhita Kal and Charak Samhita, two plants, namely Agnimanth and Tarkari, they are mentioned, which are considered as Laghu and Brihat Agnimanth respectively. But this controversy is resolved in the present context as Clerodendron Phlomyidis is considered as Laghu Agnimanth, and the Premna integrifolia is considered as Brihat Agnimanth. Both the plant Laghu and Brihat Agnimanth are similar in properties, are believed to be similar in properties. But it is also mentioned that for Lepan, that is for topical application, and Upanaha, using a poultice, in inflammatory conditions, in Shoth, Laghu Agnimanth is preferred to be used. Premna integrifolia is the Latin name of Brihat Agnimanth, whereas Clerodendron Phlomyidis is the Latin name of Laghu Agnimanth. Both the plants belongs to the family Verbenaceae. Arni, Agethu and Tarkari are the Hindi names. And in English, the plant Premna integrifolia or the Brihat Agnimanth is known as Indian headache tree. These are some of the vernacular names of Agnimanth in different regional languages. Samhitokt classification. In Charak Samhita, Agnimanth is described in Shothar, Sheet Prashashman and Anvasnopag Mahakashay. In Shushur Samhita, it is mentioned in Varunadivark, Veertarvadi, Vrat Panchmool and Vatshanchaman Varg. In Ashtang Sangrahe and Ashtang Hrade, it is described in Varunadi and Veertarvadi Ganas. Synonyms or the Pryas. Arnika, Ganikarika, Jaya, Jayanti, Shriparni, Nadei, Vajyantika and Ketu are its popular synonyms. The word Arni or Arnika is used for fire or Agni. In the context of our body, the word Arni or Arnika means that the drug which stimulates the digestive fire, that is, which have deepen in action. The synonym Jaya or Jayanti specifies that the plant or the plant part, they are used to conquer diseases or diseased conditions. The synonym Ganikarika, it means that the plant grows in gun. Gun is in groups. It means that the plant grows in groups with other trees. It specifies the gregarious nature of the plant. That is, it survives in a group. The word Shriparni, it describes the beautiful foliage of the tree. The synonym Nadei, it means that a plant naturally grows on the riverside or near some water source. The synonym Vajantika and Ketu, दे आर यूज्ड बिकॉज इट्स फ्लैग और बैनर लाइक बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स फ्लैग और बैनर लाइक इनफ्लोरेसेंसेस. टाइप्स ऑफ अग्निमंत. एज डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर इन द स्लाइड्स ऑफ इंट्रोडक्शन, देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ अग्निमंत, लघु एंड बृहद अग्निमंत. बॉटनिकली लघु अग्निमंत इज क्लारोडेंडम फ्लोमाइडिस एंड बृहद अग्निमंत इज प्रेमना इंटीग्री फोलिया. दिस टू टाइप्स ऑफ अग्निमंत आर कोटेड बाय कोटेड इन राजनिघंटु. डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन और द हैबिटेट ऑफ द प्लांट. इन इंडियन सबकॉन्टिनेंट द प्लांट इज एक्सटेंसिवली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड इन द फॉरेस्ट रीजन्स ऑफ मध्य प्रदेश, नॉर्थ ईस्ट, महाराष्ट्र, उड़ीसा, गुजरात, कर्नाटका एंड वेस्ट बंगाल. मॉर्फोलॉजी और द स्वरूप ऑफ द प्लांट. बृहद अग्निमंत इज अ लार्ज श्रब और अ स्मॉल ट्री विच कैन एक्सटेंड अप टू अ हाइट ऑफ अबाउट 10 मीटर्स. द ट्रंक, इट्स ट्रंक इज वीक, मच ब्रांच्ड एंड मोर ऑर लेस थॉर्नी इन नेचर. एक्सटर्नली द बार्क इज ब्राउनिश ग्रे इन कलर एंड इट इज फ्लेकी एंड फिशर्ड. द लीव्स और द पत्र. द प्लांट पॉजेस सिंपल अपोजिट पिटुलेटेड लीव्स. दीज लीव्स आर अबाउट 5 to 8 सेंटीमीटर इन लेंथ एंड 3 to 6 सेंटीमीटर विड्थ. द लीव्स आर ओवल टू इलिप्टिकल इन शेप एंड हैज शॉर्ट एक्यूमिनेट एपेक्स. दे हैव एंटायर मार्जिन एंड समटाइम्स द अपर पार्ट ऑफ द मार्जिन, लीव्स मार्जिन, दे आर सेरेटेड इन नेचर. द फ्लावर्स आर ग्रीनिश वाइट इन कलर विद अ यूनिक अनप्लेजेंट ऑर्डर. दे अकर्स इन टर्मिनल पेनिकुलेट कोरम्बोस इनफ्लोरेसेंस. The plant bears many fruits and these fruits are pear-shaped terminal drupes. They are about 3 to 6 millimeter in diameter. They are short like the size of a pea. Their shape is globose to obovoid. When the fruits are in unripe stage, they are green colored and later as the maturity proceeds, they turns into black color. These features are clearly visible in the underlying pictures. You can see those pictures too. Roots are the officinal part of Agnimanth, which is used therapeutically. These roots are yellowish brown in color, much branched and tortuous to cylindrical in shape. The plant starts blooming in the month of April to June and it bears fruit from August to September. The method of propagation or regeneration is by the seeds and the stem cutting of the tree. The Raspanchak of Agnimanth is similar to the previously studied Brith Panchmool plant, Bilv. So, like the bilv roots, Agnimanth is laghu ruksh in gun, kattu, tikt and kashai rasa, and it is kattu vipaki and ushnavirya. Now, coming to the chemical constituent of Agnimanth, the alkaloid pramninine, betulin, ganiarine, ganicarine, and pramniol. These are the pharmacological active constituents which are found in the roots and bark of Agnimanth. Whereas the leaves are reported to have beta-cetosterol, luteolin and clarodendron A and eflantrine as an active constituent. The next slide shows the shloka of Agnimanth. The shloka is taken from the Kuruchyadi work of Bhavaprakash Nighantu. In the shloka, it is described that Agnimanth is kattu, तिक्त कषाय एंड मधुर रस प्रिडोमिनेंट. इट हैज उष्ण वीर्य कफ वात शामक प्रॉपर्टीज एंड दीपन शोथर इन एक्शन एंड इट इज इंडिकेटेड इन पांडुरोग. कर्म. लाइक द अदर दशमूल द्रव्यास द क्लासिकल आयुर्वेदिक टेक्स्ट एंड द निघंटूज हैज डेजिग्नेटेड अग्निमंत एज अ दीपन आमपाचन शोथर एंटी इन्फ्लेमेटरी ग्राही दैट इज द एब्जॉर्बेंट ड्रग्स क्रिमिघ्न ज्वरघ्न एंटीपायरेटिक ड्रग्स अनुलोमन बाथर वेदना स्थापन मेदोहर कफ निसारक एक्सपेक्टोरेंट ड्रग्स एंड एन अनुवासनोपग ड्रग. इंडिकेशंस. इन इथनो मेडिसिन अग्निमंत कषाय इज यूज इन द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ मेनी इन्फ्लेमेटरी डिजीजेस विच इज नोन एज शोथ वात व्याधीज नाड़ीशूल न्यूरालजिया संधिवात that was arthritis, kaswas, pandurog, vishamjwar, especially in malaria, and gastrointestinal diseases like agnimandhe, adhyaman, flatulence, arsh, vibandh, and in many skin diseases. Skin diseases like sheetpit, udard, coat, visarp, etc. The root decoction is also used for general debility or the general or in general weakness and as a post-delivery tonic for mothers. The alkali that is a form of shar preparation prepared from the bark ash is used in ascites. It is specially indicated in jalodhar. Agnimanth shar is specially indicated in the condition called jalodhar or ascites. The flowers are used in neuralgia, that is nervine pain, in common cold and fever. The leaves, mainly the juice and decoction of the leaves, they are used for bathing the infants which suffers from skin infections or skin diseases. Leaves, juice or decoction is also used in vaginal irritations, for cleansing the wounds and also in the treatment of beriberi. Coming to the therapeutic use section, the therapeutic uses of Agnimanth as a single drug are limited. Mainly it is used in combination with other Bhratpanchmool Dravya or the Dashmool Dravyas. This section is further divided into external and internal uses. That is external use for local application and internal uses are for oral consumption in different diseased condition. First, we are taking the external use or the uses of Agnimanth as a local agent. In Granthi Visarp, which is also known as glandular erysipelas, Agnimanth Patra and Vansh Patra, they are made into paste and applied to the affected areas. It will surely give relief in Granthi Visarp. Vansh Patra are bamboo leaves. Second case, in case of Arsh, especially in Shushk Arsh, Avgahan Swed, which is known as Sitz Bath, with the decoction of Agnimanth, Shigru and Ashmantak Patra, reduces the inflammation in pain condition and sitting the patient in this decoction daily is beneficial in case of Shushk Arsh. In Vyang or Vyang or discoloration of the face, which is also known as freckles, Agnimanth bark paste pounded with Ajadugdh, it should be applied on the face to reduce the acne, freckles and facial discoloration. Similarly, in Vranshut, a paste prepared with Matulung, Agnimant, Devdaru, Sunthi, Hinsra, and Rasna is applied locally over the inflammatory region. The second slide of therapeutic uses shows the internal uses of Agnimant in various diseased conditions. The first disease is Sheetpit, which is also known as urticaria. Urticaria is a skin disease of Kapha Pitta Dushti. In urticaria, daily intake of Agnimant Mool Kalk with Gogrit for a week gives relief in Sheetpit. In Vasa Meh and Ikshu Meh, these are the types of Prameh or diabetes. Agnimant and Shinchipa is Shisham, Mulkwat, the decoction of the root decoction of Agnimant and Shinchipa is recommended for daily use. In Stholye, which is also known as obesity, it's a type of Medhorog, daily intake of Agnimant Mool or Patraswaras with Shilajit powder. It helps in reducing the excessive weight. In another condition, which is known as Udarshoot, Agnimant Kwat or Agnimant Shar, it should be used daily to get relief in inflammatory conditions of Udar or the stomach. Parts use, the root, bark and the leaves, they are used ethnomedicinally, and the decoction of the root or the bark is indicated in a dose of about 50 to 100 ml. The root, bark or the leaves in powder form is required to be used in a dose of about 3 to 6 grams. Formulations: Dashmularisht, Dashmulkwat, Agnimant Kashai, Narayan Tel and Dhanvantri Ghrit. These are some of the popular marketed formulations of Agnimant. Thank you very much for your patience learning.